As we have seen in the last slides, that human resource management is a combination of three different words, which are humans, resources, and management. When we combine these three words, so that we will get the definition of human resource management. So let me describe the definition of human resource management in a very simple way or words. That is, human resource management is a process of using human resources in an effective and efficient way to achieve the organizational goals. So let me explain a bit. In an organization, there are a lot of employees who used to work in different departments. Of course, human resource management, the basic purpose is to make it possible to coordinate with the departments in such a way that employees of that departments give a good performance, so that the goal of an organization can be achieved in a well-organized way. So I hope that you got the basic definition of human resource management. So let's move on to the scope of human resource management. The scope of human resource management is very extensive, and it consists of all functions which come under the banner of human resource management. These are the different scope of human resource management. And the first one is human resource planning. The second one is job analysis and design. The third one is recruitment and selection. Then orientation and induction. Training and development. Performance appraisal. And the last one is compensation planning. So moving to the scope of human resource management, first of all, we are going to check what is human resource planning. Basically, it is a procedure in which human resource identifies how many empty positions available in the organization and in which department staff is exceeding and how to control this. It means that human resource planning is a procedure that identifies the current and future needs of human resources to achieve the goals of the company. So we can say, maybe we need to identify staff requirement due to new opening of a branch, or we need to reduce the staff due to closing of any branch. So that comes under the human resource planning. So let's take the example of human resource planning. Let's say a company want to open its branch. So human resource planning will be like, how much staff is required and how much staff requiring different department of the company. So the company will start hiring the new employees. Then the branch operation will start. So this is a simple example of human resource planning. Okay, the next scope of human resource management is job analysis and design. So let me explain the meaning of job analysis. Job analysis is a procedure of determining and documenting all the relevant information about a specific job, including the duties involved, the knowledge and expertise need to do the job, the responsibilities attached to the job, and the abilities required to perform that job successfully. Basically, it's a complete analysis of the job in which we check the duties involved in that job and the knowledge and the skills which are required to perform the job. This is called job analysis. So let me explain the meaning of job design. Basically, it's a method of structuring work and assigning the specific activities at individual or on a group level. Basically, it determines the responsibilities of an employee. It means that it contains the information related to the task which an employee needs to perform during his or her duty hours. And it also determines the scope of decision making. It means it determines about which task an employee can make decision, or about which subordinates he can make decisions. It also determines the level of satisfaction and his productivity. That means that how much productive an employee is and what a company or a department expect from his or her employee to perform. That is called job design. The next scope of human resource management is recruitment and selection. The meaning of recruitment. Recruitment is a method of searching for potential employees and motivating them to apply for the available job opportunities in the organization. It includes the entire hiring process from commencement of job to the individual recruit's assimilation into the company. So basically, recruitment is a process to attract the potential employees so that a company can hire them. This process is known as recruitment. Now, let me explain the meaning of selection. The selection is a screening process, or it's a process of choosing individuals with the help of appropriate selection tools and methods who have pertaining qualifications to fill job vacancies in an organization. Training can be given with the help of different methods like resume screening, telephonic interview, and then the interview with the human resource manager and then departmental managers. And all these are the things coming under the term selection. Now, after recruitment and selection, the next scope which we are going to discuss is orientation and induction. The induction is a process of introducing new employees to his employer or organization and work atmosphere. And this is more informal as compared to the orientation. So now then comes the term orientation. On the other hand, it's a well-planned program which intends to reorganize a new employee and making him familiarized with his or her department job role and work culture. So orientation basically is a formal as compared to the induction, which is informal. Now, another scope which is very, very important, that is training and development. Training, training is a process of providing necessary skills to the employee for doing job successfully, expertly, and qualitatively. It is not a continuous process, but it's a periodical and given in a particular time. Normally, training will be given by a professional trainer in a related field or job. Let's say a company is going to install a new plant for manufacturing of new product. So he need to train its employees which can work on that to plan to manufacture that product. This is called training. And some professional trainer who know how to create that plan will give the training to the employees. So this is a part of training. And then comes development. Development is a sketch for helping employees to build up their skills, knowledge, and ability, which in turn improves an organization's efficiency. So development is a draft in which employees update their skills, their knowledge, and their ability so they can perform in a better way. This is called development. Then performance appraisal. Performance appraisal is a very, very important scope of human resource management. Performance appraisal is a technique by which the job performance of an employee is noted and evaluated. Basically, it is used to decide future incentives and the promotion of employees. So another thing which we can decide on the basis of performance appraisal is that where an employee lacks in its knowledge, what he needs to learn more so that he can perform better. So this is a basic function of performance appraisal. Then move to the last scope of human resource management, that is compensation planning. A compensation plan refers to all the elements of a compensation package. It may include pay and benefits, and it also includes the way in which it will be paid and for what purpose employees receive bonus, salary, increment, and incentive. It all means all the things in which we decide that how we will pay an employee and what are the benefits which we will pay to an employee and how we will pay it and in what circumstances we will pay those benefits to an employee. Let's take an example of a bonus that in compensation plan, we will decide that if an employee make a certain amount of sale, then we will give him or her a certain amount of bonus. So these all the things come under the term compensation planning.